So, what you're trying to say is that you fell here from another world? But when you wanted to leave and go on to the next world, your path was blocked by some unknown god?
Outlanders, your journey ends here. Who are you? The sustainer of heavenly principles. The arrogation of mankind ends now.
And just like that, the god took away my brother. Some kind of seal was cast upon me, and I lost my power. So while we used to travel from world to world, we are now trapped here.
How many years ago was it? I don't know. But I intend to find out. After I awoke, I was all alone. Right up until I met you 2 months ago.
Yeah, Paimon really owes you for that. Otherwise, Paimon likely would have drowned. So Paimon will do her best to be a great guide. We should head off. Let's get going! depletes stamina, and depleted stamina takes time to recover. Okay, let's take the route we planned. We're off to a Statue of the Seven! Which of the seven are you looking for exactly? Of the Seven! There are a few of these statues scattered across the land to show the Seven's protection over the world. Among the Seven Gods, this god controls the wind. Paimon's not sure whether the god you're looking for is the Animal God, but... Paimon will take you to the Animal God's place first, and there's the reason why. As we all know, poetry and language flow like the wind. There'll definitely be someone there who knows about your brother. At least that's what Paimon thinks. Whether the gods actually answer you is a different story. You never know unless you try. So let's hop to it. Did you just feel the elements of the world? Seems all you had to do was just touch the statue and you got the power of Animal. As much as they may want it, people in this world can never get a hold of powers as easily as you. It's a bit rude to say that about the power the gods just gave you. If we keep heading west from here, we'll eventually reach Mondstadt, the City of Freedom. Mondstadt is the city of wind because they worship the god of Animal. So perhaps, because you got power from the god of Animal, you can find some clues there. There are also lots of bards there, so perhaps one of them has heard news of your brother. Let's move then! The elements in this world responded to your prayers, and Paimon thinks that's a lovely sign. Ha! Nya! Ha! Nya! stars you got from the Statue of the Seven. Oh, Paimon's so jealous. Why doesn't Paimon get cool fighting powers?
Yeah! Don't be afraid. It's all right now. I'm back.
Is he talking to a dragon?
Who's there?
Weirdo who was talking to the dragon. Of course not. Oh, what's that? There's some kind of shiny red thingy on the big rock over there. Let's go take a closer look. Be careful! Paimon doesn't have a good feeling about this. Paimon's never seen a stone like this before, so Paimon can't tell what it is. All Paimon knows is that it's dangerous. Best we put it away for now. Okay, we've got it. Now let's get out of here!
Yeah.
May the Animo God protect you, stranger. I am Amber, outrider for the Knights of Favonius. You don't look like citizens of Mondstadt. Explain yourselves.
We're not looking for trouble.
That's what all the troublemakers say. Doesn't sound like a local name to me. And this mascot, what's the deal with it?
Hey! That's even worse than being a mascot!
So to sum it up, you're traveling partners, right? Well, look, there's been a large dragon sighted around Mondstadt recently. Best you get inside the city as soon as possible. It's not far from here. I'll escort you there.
Oh, aren't you out here for some other reason?
I am, but not to worry. I can keep you both safe while doing that too. Besides, I'm still not sure if I can trust you two just yet. Oh, I'm sorry. Probably not something I should say as a knight. I give you my apologies, strange yet respectable travelers.
That sounded so fake!
Do you have something against the type of language usage prescribed by the Knights of Favonius Handbook? Suspicious travelers, what are you doing in Mondstadt?
She got separated from her brother during a really, really long journey. Paimon is her travel buddy, helping her to find her brother.
Oh, looking for your family? Huh. Okay, let me finish my other stuff first, and then I can help you put up posters around the city.
What exactly is it you need to finish doing first?
It's simple. You'll understand in a bit. Thank you.
way.
These monsters have been getting too close to the city recently. My task this time is to clear out their camp. A little with your moves there. Thanks for the backup. How'd it feel?
Now that you mention it, how is it the Hilly Trolls ended up here? These creatures don't seem like the type to set up camp so close to cities like this.
Exactly. It's more normal for them to be much further out in the wilderness. But because the dragon, Storm Terror, has been around a lot more recently, our orchards have been destroyed and the local market has been affected as well. When the storms hit, we usually end up with at least a few injuries, so the Knights of Favonius have been tied up doing the best they can to defend the area.
So these annoying creatures have been getting closer and closer to the city?
Exactly. That said, clearing this camp helped make the area a little bit safer. Come with me. A responsible knight must make sure to see you to the city safely.
The Grandmaster has not returned?
Officially introduce the city of wind, dandelions, and freedom. Travelers under the protection of the Knights of Favonius, welcome to Mondstadt.
Finally, no more having to camp outdoors. But the city folk don't look too cheery.
Everyone's been put out of place by storm terror recently. But everything will turn out fine as long as Jean's with us.
Jean?
Acting Grand Master of the Knights of Favonius, Jean, Defender of Mondstadt. With Jean on our side, surely even the vicious Storm Terror will be no match for us. Before I take you guys to the Knights of Favonius headquarters, I have a present for you, Traveler. It's a reward for helping me clear out that Hilichurl camp.
Hey! Why doesn't Paimon get a reward?
Because this reward is useless to you, Paimon. But I'll treat you to a traditional Mondstadt delicacy, sticky honey roast.
Sticky honey roast!
Come with me. We'll head to the city's, high ground. This used to be a bustling street, but with so many storm terror attacks recently, the usual crowds are nowhere to be seen. Except for the local tavern near the city wall over there. They haven't been affected. If anything, their business is better than ever. So, the present I want to give you is a wind glider. Outriders use them to ride the wind, and the people of Mondstadt love using them too. I brought you here to give it to you, so you can experience it right away.
Wow, you're really excited about these wind gliders, huh?
Well, that's because the wind is the heart and soul of Mondstadt. Alrighty then, enough talk. Let's give it a whirl. It's easy to use, but you still need to pay attention to my instructions. The sky.
Hey.
preventing your fall with the power of 1,000 winds. Now, concentrate. See yourself grasping the wind. Harness its energy.
You hurt?
You've actually got the power to go up against the dragon. Are you a new ally? Or a new storm?
Terror is attacking Mondstadt itself! Kaya, Traveler, you've come at the right time. We must...
Hold on, Amber. Are you perhaps forgetting to introduce us?
Oh, right. This is Kaya, our cavalry captain. These two are travelers from afar.
From afar? Is that all we know of them?
Long story short...
I see. Welcome to Mondstadt, though you haven't arrived at the best of times, I'm afraid. I understand the anguish of being separated from family. I'm not really sure why you're looking for the Animo God. Oh, but everyone has their secrets, right? Relax. I won't press you for more. First and foremost, on behalf of the Knights of Favonius, I would like to extend our thanks to you for your help just now. Your fight to defend the city against the dragon just now was witnessed by no small number of citizens. The acting Grand Master of the Knights of Favonius is also very interested in meeting you, and formally invites you both to our headquarters.
Thank you.
seems to be the Knights of Favonia's headquarters. Let's head in.
There have been sightings of storm terror outside the city. Once we meet, we must...
Jean, what's the hurry? I thought we agreed to meet them here.
There have been sightings of storm terror outside the city. Once we meet, we must...
Relax. I'll lend a hand when the time comes.
Jean, I've brought them. And once it was over, I brought them straight here.
Mondstadt welcomes you, Windborne travelers. I am Jean, acting Grand Master of the Knights of Favonius. This is Lisa, our resident.
Oh, are you sweeties here to help us out? You're both so adorable. Sadly, the timing is regrettable. Storm terror has caused quite a ruckus in the region since its recent resurgence. Simply put, Mondstadt's elemental sphere and ley lines are now akin to a yarn ball in the paws of a kitten. For a mage, it couldn't get much worse. My skin is one elemental particle away from a full-blown breakout.
If it weren't for this interference, the Knights of Favonius would have better ways to help you than just putting up missing person posters. We simply ask that you repose in Mondstadt while we help you seek out your brother.
Paimon will help too.
Good. In that case, we need a plan.
With Stormterror now directly attacking Mondstadt, we may have an opportunity to cut this problem off at the source. Lisa has revealed the sources of Storm Terror's power with her detection magic.
Is that so?
They're located in the abandoned Four Winds temples. Storm Terror's ability to whip up these kinds of storms can be attributed to it drawing power from the temples.
Our objective is to deal with three of the four temples. I trust everyone understands why we are only dealing with three.
Paimon doesn't.
Knights of Favonius, time is against us. The storm is rampant. There's no point in maintaining a defensive position. All right, we need to take initiative and act before the situation escalates.